Right. So I hope the screen is visible to you, right? Is it visible screen? Fine. So let us carry on from the same slide where we had left in the last lecture. So we were talking about the common base stage, and in this common base stage, we had seen the input impedance, how to calculate. Now let us talk about biasing of this common base stage. In fact, we want to discuss about this emitter resistor here. Now in the biasing of this common base stage, you will find that the emitter resistor. Okay, so this is important here. I mean, you cannot neglect this emitter resistor while biasing the common base stage circuit, because the emitter current, so that has to go through this resistor. So this resistor actually provides a path for this bias current IC and then IE. So without this, the current cannot flow. Okay, I mean the current cannot go through C1 and RS. C1 will block that DC current, the bias current, right? So you need to have an emitter resistor over here. Now, but the problem after having an emitter resistance would be that the input impedance of this would get lower, right? So because of this emitter resistor, the input impedance of this circuit goes down. So how it goes down? So for that, let us do some analysis. So let us say at this point, looking into the emitter from this point, okay? So the impedance, so we had calculated the impedance looking into emitter is 1 by GM. So let us say that Rin dash is the impedance, which is 1 by GM looking into the emitter of this BJT. Now this 1 by GM is in parallel with RE. So that is actual total Rin, right? So Rin, that is input impedance looking from here. Okay. So that is equal to the parallel combination of 1 by GM and RE, right? So Rin, I can write Rin as Rin dash or 1 by GM parallel to RE. So which is written over here also. Rin is 1 by GM parallel to RE. Or this can be written as 1 by GM RE divided by 1 by GM plus RE. Yeah, parallel combination. Okay. Now, this RE lowers the input impedance, right? So to justify this point, let us choose 1 by GM as 50 ohm, right? So let us choose 1 by GM as 50 ohm. We had earlier also chosen 1 by GM as 50 ohm. And without RE, the input impedance would be then equal to 1 by GM, that is 50 ohms. So without RE, the input impedance is 1 by GM or 50 ohm. And also without RB, right? So RB is also not present. Now when we choose RE, that is when we bring in RE, and let us say that RE is also 50 ohms. So we have RE as 50 ohm, 1 by GM also 50 ohm. So I can find out input impedance using this relation. That is 1 by GM times RE, that is 50 times 50 divided by 1 by GM plus RE, that is 50 plus 50. So this is equal to 25. Okay. So that is input impedance with RE is 25, and without RE it is 50 ohms. So with RE it is 25, and without RE it is 50 ohms. So we see that the effect of this RE is that the input impedance goes down. That is, this RE lowers the input impedance, and this is important also, so we cannot neglect also this RE. Now, instead of this complete circuit at the input, one can simplify this circuit, that is towards it at the emitter part here, by saying that now instead of this I have input impedance Rin appearing at node X, right? So this is Rin, so I can modify and I can create this circuit. Okay, that is, we have Rin, that is input impedance, Rs, okay, this node X. Right. Now I can find out Vx at this point. Right. So Vx would be simply Vin multiplied by Rin divided by Rs plus Rn. Okay. So simply using a voltage divider, that is Vx is Vin times Rin divided by Rs plus Rn. Okay. So I can write Vx, Rin Vin divided by Rn plus Rs. And Rin is input impedance, which we have already calculated here. So we can put this input impedance Rin from here into this. So we get a relationship. Okay. Now we see Vx is present here, Vin is present here. Okay. So I can find out Vx by Vin. Okay. So I can find out Vx by Vin from this equation. So I need this Vx by Vin in finding out the gain. So the gain of this circuit would be, if I calculate Vx by Vin and if I can calculate Vout by Vx, I can find out the gain. So Vx by Vin I have calculated, now Vout by Vx we need to find. Okay. So Vout by Vx is, that is Vout at this point and Vx at this point, which is actually the gain of this circuit. Okay. And the gain of this circuit, which is common base, is VmRc. Okay. So the gain of this, considering Vout by Vx, so that is equal to the gain, which is GmRc. Okay. So Vout by Vx is known. So I'll put Vout by Vx as GmRc and Vx by Vin from here. So I can find out the total gain, that is Vout by Vin. Okay. So the total gain of the circuit can be found as this much. Okay. Now this problem of reduction in input impedance, okay, because of Re. So we saw that there is a reduction in input impedance because of this Re. So this problem can be solved, if we assume or if we fix Re much greater than 1 by Gm. So if I can choose Re much greater than 1 by Gm, then this problem of reduction of input impedance due to Re, so this can be solved. Okay. So to justify this, let us consider Re is greater than 1 by Gm. Okay. And which you choose again 1 by Gm as 50 ohms. Okay. So we choose again 1 by Gm as 50 ohms. And since Re has to be much greater than 1 by Gm, so let us say Re is 10 times 1 by Gm. Okay. So that is Re is 500 ohms. Okay. Re has to be much greater than 1 by Gm. Let us say Re is 10 times 1 by Gm. So that is 500 ohms. Okay. Now try to calculate input impedance with this Re and 1 by Gm. So we calculate input impedance by the same previous formula, that is here. That is 1 by Gm Re divided by 1 by Gm plus Re. Okay. So if I calculate it and put these values, I get 50 multiplied by 500 divided by 50 plus 500. Okay. That is 25,000 by 550, which is 45 ohms. Okay. So now I am getting input impedance as 45 ohms with Re, and without Re it is 50 ohms. Okay. So we see that by choosing RE much greater than 1 by GM, we are able to, I mean, this 50 and 45, this is almost same, right? So there is some loss, but that loss is very small. But in the previous case, we saw that the input impedance was 50 without RE, but when we added RE, it became 25. So this is a huge drop in the input impedance. But when you consider the emitter resistance much greater than 1 by GM, then this drop in input impedance is almost negligible. Now, in the common base circuit, one can bias this circuit by adding these two resistors R1 and R2. So we had seen this voltage divider biasing would provide a better stability to this circuit, right? So we had already discussed some time back, okay? But there is a problem by adding these two resistances. Though we understand that these two resistances are used for biasing this BJT, okay? So that is for setting this VB here. You are using these two resistances, okay? So VB can be found. That is, VB would be equal to VCC multiplied by R2 by R1 plus R2, which would be equal to VThevenin, right? So this VThevenin or VB is set by these two resistances. But then the problem is that this R1 and R2 voltage divider, this lowers the gain. That is, gain of this circuit goes down because of this R1 and R2. Now the solution to this problem, that is lowering in the gain because of this R1 and R2, would be that if I can short these two resistances at the particular frequency of interest at which I want to amplify my AC input signal. So high frequency AC input signal, whatever frequency is of interest, so I can choose a capacitor, so that matches my frequency of interest for which this capacitor will be short, so that this R1 and R2 will also be shorted. Because in the small signal model, this VCC will be shorted to ground, so that R1 and R2 will be parallel to this capacitor CB. Now, when this capacitor is short, so that means R1 and R2 are also short. So that is the effect of these two resistances, R1 and R2, so they can be nullified while amplifying an AC signal of any particular frequency of interest. So depending upon this frequency of interest, the value of CB can be chosen. So one can think of designing any common base stage circuit, common base stage circuit. So for example, this circuit can be designed for these parameters. Let us say that these are the parameters given to me. That is, VCC is given, IE is beta, VA is also given. Then let us say gain is also given to me as 10, and input resistance, that is input impedance, so that is also given to me as 50 ohms. Now I have to design the circuit for these parameters. So that is, I have to find out RC, RE, R1 and R2. So I can do that by saying that input impedance is 50 ohm, which is equal to 1 by GM, if RE is much greater than 1 by GM, right? So we say RE is much greater than 1 by GM. So that is, let us say RE is 10 times GM, so RE is 500 ohms. Then gain is GMRC for this circuit, which is given 10. And GM is known to us. GM is 50 ohm, sorry, 1 by 50 ohm we have chosen. So RC will be 500 ohm then. Then the collector currents. So that can be written as GM is IC by VT. So GM is known, VT is also known, 26 millivolts. So collector current can be calculated, 0.52. Now from collector current, The base current can also be calculated. IC is beta by beta IB. Beta is given to us. So IB can be calculated. Then VB. Okay, so VB can also be calculated. That is this VB. Okay, so VB is actually equal to VBE plus drop across this RE. Okay, VB is VBE plus drop across this RE, which is IERE. Let us say IE is flowing in this RE. So VB can be written as IERE plus VBE. So IE is known to me now. IE is equal to IC. Okay. Because IB is very small. And VBE is also known by this relation, VT log IC by IS, which is 0.899. So I can find out this relation from this. VB can be calculated. And then R1 and R2 can be calculated. Okay. So because R1 and R2 have a relation with VB, that is this VB is VCC times R2 by R1 plus R2. So from this relation, R1 and R2 can also be calculated, as we have done previously also. Okay. So this way one can design a common base amplifier stage circuit. Now let us talk about another topology, which is a common collector. Okay. Or this is also called emitter follower. So in this common collector, one has to remember that input is applied to the base and output is always sensed at the emitter, right? So output is sensed at the emitter and input is applied at the base. Okay. Now in this common collector, let us say that this circuit is given to us. Okay. So if we are supposed to calculate V out from here, right? So V out can be written simply as V in minus VBE, right? So V in minus VBE will give me V out. Okay. V in minus VE, or simply we can write VBE, VBE. Right, VBE, this is VB minus VE, or VB is V in, so I write V in, and VE, that is at the emitter, it is V out. Okay, so I can write VBE as V in minus V out, or I can write this V out is V in minus VBE. So all these are same, that is this one also, right? So all three are same. Okay. So VBE is V in minus V out. So in this common collector or emitter follower, if I apply V in 1 at the base, I'll get some output at the emitter. Let us say that output is V out 1. Okay. Now when I change V in 1 to V in plus delta V in, that is input changes by delta V in, so there is a change in output also, and that change is delta V out. Okay. So output changes from V out 1 to V out, sorry, delta V out. Okay. And the difference in input and output is VBE. Okay. That is the difference in V in and V out is VBE. So we have already written over here also. So the difference in input and output is VBE, right? So that is this difference between input and output is VBE. Okay. Okay, so V in and V out differ by VBE. Okay. Now this common collector configuration is also called unity gain or emitter follower. Okay. So unity gain, because the gain is 1. Okay. So gain is 1 would mean that V out by V in, so that should be equal to 1. Okay. So when VA is infinity, right? That is no early effect. So the gain should be 1, but that is only valid for this circuit where you provide a constant current source on the emitter. So if you are putting a constant current source on the emitter, then only this is true. Okay. So how this is true? So when you are applying a constant current source I1 on the emitter, so that means that constant emitter current flows. Okay. So constant emitter current means constant collector current. Okay. So emitter current is constant, so that means collector current is also constant. And if collector current is constant, so then that would mean that VBE, so that is also constant. So remember, we had commented sometime that how IC varies with VBE. So if you increase VBE, IC also increases. Okay, collector current. But if collector current is constant, so that means VBE should also be constant. Okay. So this constant current source at the emitter side actually fixes the collector current also and the base emitter voltage also. Okay. So the base emitter voltage is fixed, okay, because collector current or emitter current is constant. Now in this context only we can say Vout by Vin is 1. Okay. So for example, let us say that input V in, okay, so that is or maybe let us say that, yeah, let us say that VB is 2 volts, okay, and VE is 1 volt. Okay. That is VB here is 2 volt and VE which is coming in out to is 1 volt initially. Okay, so that VBE is 1 volt. Now VB is increased by delta V in, and that delta V in is, let us say, 0.5 volts. Okay. And now we'll also assume that we have placed this current source here. Okay. So that this VBE is now constant, 1 volt. Okay. So when we place this, VBE is constant. Now if VB, that is input here, changes by delta V in, that is 0.5 volt. Okay. So VE, that is the output, so that also changes by 0.5 volt. Okay. So that means my input is 2.5 volt and output is 1.5 volt. Okay. And the gain is 1. So gain is measured here as delta V out by V in. So gain is measured now, that is change in output voltage divided by change in input voltage. So then only one can say that gain is 1. Otherwise gain is not 1, right? 2.5 by 1.5. So this is not 1. Okay. So we say that it is a unity gain amplifier or unity gain circuit only in this context. That is the change in output divided by change in input. So that is equal to 1 because my VBE is constant. Okay. So why VBE is constant? Because IE is constant, IC is constant. Okay. So hence delta V out is delta V in. And hence we say that the gain of this circuit is 1. Okay. So otherwise the gain is never 1. Fine. So this is called unity gain or emitter follower. That is, the output follows the input. So whatever is present at the input, okay, so that comes on the emitter. Okay, so this is also called emitter follower configuration. Okay, so maybe you might be knowing this. Okay, so now let us also draw the small signal model of this emitter follower and do some calculations. Okay. So the small signal model of emitter follower, that is common collector, is drawn over here. So you have RPi, you have RE over here, GMVPi. Okay. And the collector is shorted to ground. At the base, you are providing input, and at the emitter, you are getting output. Okay. Let us assume VA as infinity. Okay. So one can write a relationship. That is, one can find out V out here. So V out can be found by saying that V in minus V pi. Okay. V in minus V pi is equal to V out. So one can write V in minus V pi is equal to V out, or V pi is V in minus V out. Okay. Then one can apply KCL at the emitter. That is here. That is, current through the emitter is equal to current through this plus current through this. Okay. So current through this is Vm by R pi. Sorry, V pi by R pi. And current through this Gm V pi, so that is equal to current through this, that is V out by RE. Now in this we put V pi, right? So V pi we place from here into this. So this becomes this equation, and then finally it can be arranged in this form. That is, V out by V in is RE by RE plus 1 by Gm. Now for this circuit, from the small signal model, you will find that the voltage gain is less than 1, and it is also positive. So the voltage gain is less than 1 and positive. So that can be also justified by taking one example here. So let us say RE is much greater than 1 by GM, and let us say 1 by GM is 50, so RE would be 500, and put these value here. Okay. So once you put this value here, you get gain V out by V in as 500 by 550, which is less than 1. Okay. So that means this is true. So small signal gain of emitter follower is less than 1. Now one can consider a emitter resistor over here in this configuration, common collector. Now this circuit can be simplified to saying that I have this circuit now, and then if I can find out the input impedance here at this point, then I'll connect this RE in parallel with the input impedance which is present here. Okay. That is, impedance while looking into the emitter, if I find out that, then this RE will be parallel to that impedance. So the impedance looking into the emitter side we had calculated as 1 by GM. Okay. So that is, this impedance is 1 by GM. So that you can verify. I mean, I'll take you back to the previous lectures where we had seen the impedance while looking into the emitter in a common emitter configuration. This one here, right? So impedance while looking into the emitter is 1 by GM here. So this 1 by GM is valid here also. That is, impedance looking into the emitter is 1 by GM. So that means this 1 by GM is parallel to RE. So that means instead of drawing this transistor, I can represent this by a resistor, sorry, a impedance 1 by GM. So that is, I can modify this circuit to this. That is, I have V in, I have 1 by GM, and I have RE also. Okay. Now I can find out this V out by V in, the gain. So V out can be found by simply again dividing this V in over 1 by GM and RE. So V out can be written as V in, right, multiplied by RE divided by RE plus R सॉरी आर ई प्लस वन बाई जी एम. सो वन कैन कैलकुलेट दी वोल्टेज गेन दिस वे ऑल्सो. नाउ वन कैन इंक्लूड द इफेक्ट ऑफ सोर्स रेजिस्टेंस और बेस रेजिस्टेंस इन कॉमन एमिटर कॉन्फिगुरेशन. वी हैड कॉल्ड इट बेस रेजिस्टेंस बट हियर सिंस इनपुट इज अप्लाइड एट द बेस एंड दैट इनपुट मे हैव सम सोर्स रेजिस्टेंस सो दैट इज आर एस. सो वी कंसिडर इट आर एस इंस्टेड ऑफ आर बी हियर. सो अगेन दिस सर्किट कैन बी आई मीन दिस आर ई कैन बी नेग्लेक्टेड and one can find out the impedance looking into this port emitter side. Okay, now with base resistance or source resistance we had found the impedance looking into the emitter. Okay, so I'll take you to the previous lecture where we had calculated this. Here, so we had mentioned for common base stage with base resistance, the impedance looking into the emitter is 1 by Gm plus Rb by beta plus 1. Okay. So same 1 by Gm plus Rb by beta plus 1 will take over there. So instead of Rb, we have Rs. Okay. So that is impedance looking into the emitter now has modified. From 1 by Gm to 1 by Gm plus Rs by beta plus 1. Okay. So we'll write the same here. Here. So that is this impedance with Rs would be 1 by Gm plus Rs by beta plus 1, which we have already calculated. So this is now in parallel with RE. Okay. So I can now modify this circuit into this. So from there, here I can calculate V out by V in. Again using voltage divider, that is V in can be divided on this part also and this part also. Okay. So V out can be found as V in multiplied by RE divided by this term. That is 1 by Gm plus Rs by beta plus 1 plus Re. So V out by V in can be calculated as this much. Right. So gain can be calculated this way with source resistance in emitter follower circuit. Now similarly, the input impedance of emitter follower can be calculated. Now in a emitter follower, the input is applied at the base. So input impedance will be calculated by looking into the base. Okay. So looking into the base, one can find out the input impedance. Okay. Now this input impedance looking into the base will be similar to what we had calculated for common emitter amplifier with emitter degeneration and collector resistance. And looking into the base. So we had calculated this. I'll show you. I'll go back to the previous lecture. And show you. Here we had calculated. Yeah, here. Right. So here we had calculated input impedance, right? Input impedance of degenerated common emitter stage. Input impedance while looking into the base. Okay. So which is R pi plus beta plus 1 Re. Right? So we got this. Input impedance looking into the base is R pi plus beta plus 1 Re. So same is valid for this circuit also. That is this R pi plus beta plus 1 Re is the input impedance. R pi plus beta plus 1 Re. Okay. So input impedance here is R pi plus beta plus 1 Re. So we don't need to calculate again. We can calculate, but we don't need to calculate because it is already calculated for common emitter. So simply we'll inspect this circuit and compare it with the common emitter circuit, and if there are similarities, so we will just inspect and decide what could be the input impedance. Right? You don't need to calculate it again. But yes, if you don't remember that part, so then of course you can calculate here Vx by Ix. Right? So you have to find out Vx by Ix exactly in the same way as we had done for common emitter. Now you will also notice that in this common collector pair, the we can start from here. That is, then we'll come on to this emitter current and base current relation. Okay. So we understand that in a transistor, beta is alpha by 1 minus alpha, or alpha is beta by 1 plus beta. Okay. And this equation is also true for all BJTs. That is, IC is alpha IE, and IC is also equal to beta IB. Okay. So from this, I can find IE. That is, IE would be beta IB by alpha. And if I write alpha as beta by 1 plus beta, okay, so IE can be written as IB times 1 plus beta. Okay, so IE is IB times 1 plus beta. That is, whatever base current is flowing here, okay, so IE would be equal to 1 plus beta times IB. That is, this emitter current would be equal to 1 plus beta times IB. Okay. So this is IE here, okay, based on this. Now we have commented that the emitter follower has a gain which is 1, right? It's a unity gain amplifier which has a gain of 1. Okay. So now the question is where we would use this circuit which has got gain of only 1, right? So no amplification is being provided, so what is the use of this emitter follower? Okay. So one can use it as a buffer, right? So answer is that it can be used as a buffer. So buffer, that means you know, we have two circuits, let us say C1 and C2. Okay. So in between these two circuits, for connecting these two circuits, in between you can put a buffer. Okay. So this common collector or emitter follower act as a buffer between two circuits. Okay. So those two circuits could be, let us say this is my amplifier C1 and C2 is my load, or let us say speaker. Okay. Now I can connect my amplifier to speaker via a buffer or emitter follower. Okay. So why do we need to connect it this way? Okay. So for that, let us consider this example where we are directly trying to connect the amplifier to the output load speaker. Right. So this part is my amplifier, common collector, not common collector. Let us say, yeah, this is common emitter amplifier. Okay, let us say this is my amplifier. Okay, and I am connecting the output of the amplifier to the speaker. Right? So speaker is my load. Okay. Now we had discussed that because this speaker is associated with very small speaker resistance. So because of this small speaker resistance, the gain, so that actually goes down, right? So gain is affected, or gain is degraded because of this small speaker resistance. Okay? So the gain is GMRC parallel to R speaker. Okay? And we understand why C1 is used, so we'll not discuss it again. Okay? But yes, we understand the gain of this goes down because of small speaker resistance. Okay. Now to overcome this thing, that is to overcome the reduction in gain, one can put a buffer in between. That is, emitter follower stage can be inserted in between. So what it does is, let us say that the input impedance we calculate here at this point. So the input impedance at this point, we understand the input impedance of this pair is large. So the input impedance that we calculate here at the base is given by, we had calculated here input impedance looking into the base. This is R pi 1 plus beta R e. So input impedance is R pi 1 plus beta R e. That is R pi of 2 transistor 2, beta of transistor 2, and the load, that is R e. So that is R speaker here. So R pi 2 1 plus beta 2 R e. So this is my input impedance of this Q2. Okay. So this impedance is now in parallel with RC here. Okay. So this is my R in 1. So this is in parallel with RC. So instead of a small speaker resistance, now you have a larger resistance. Okay. So because of this, the gain degradation, the gain degradation that we saw here, so that may not be present here. Okay. So to justify again this point, one can put a small value of speaker here and calculate gain with suitable GM. Let us say 1 by GM is 50. Okay. Collector resistance, let us say 1K. Speaker resistance, let us say 20 ohm. Okay. And calculate the gain here. And then similarly, here one can consider RC as 1, fine. Okay, and R in large, so that can also be taken as 1. So the gain is, the gain can be calculated then. Okay. So it can be found that the gain here would be smaller compared to the gain that you calculate here. Okay. So that means this emitter follower can be used as a buffer. Okay. Now the output impedance of emitter follower can also be calculated. Okay. So output impedance, that is output is taken here on the emitter. So output impedance means while looking into the emitter from here. So that would be my output impedance. Okay. So before that, I would also like to find out impedance looking from this point V out towards Q1. So that impedance is, we have already calculated, 1 by GM RS by beta plus 1. Okay, so I'll again show you where we had calculated. I'll go back and show you that looking into the emitter, the impedance is 1 by GM. Looking into the emitter, the impedance is 1 by GM, RB by beta plus 1 or RS by beta plus 1 in case of common collector. So we'll write the same value over here for finding out the output impedance of common collector. We'll write the same value here. Okay. So that is this 1 by GM plus RS by beta plus 1 is in parallel with RE. Okay. So that is actually my total output resistance. Okay. So which is written over here. R out is 1 by GM plus RS by beta plus 1 parallel to RE. Okay. Now you will find that an emitter follower lowers the source impedance by a factor of beta plus 1 for improved driving capability. Okay. Lowers the source impedance by factor of beta plus 1 for improving the driving capability. The follower is good voltage buffer because it has high input impedance and low output impedance. So this is one of the most important characteristics of emitter follower, that is input impedance is large, okay, and output impedance is very low or small. Then one can include the effect of early effect in the calculation of gain, input impedance and output impedance. So this effect can be calculated by assuming R naught, that is the early effect, the modeling parameter for early effect R naught in parallel with RA, right? So though R naught is in between collector and emitter, but in the small signal you will short collector to ground. So when you short collector to ground, then RE will be, sorry, R naught will be in parallel to RA. So considering R naught parallel to RE, one can modify gain equation, input impedance and output impedance that were calculated earlier. Okay. So earlier we had calculated gain as R naught by R naught plus RS by beta plus 1. So simply we will, sorry, we had calculated RE by RE plus RS by beta plus 1 by GM. So wherever we see RE, just put R naught in parallel with RE. Okay. So in the gain equation, we put RE parallel to R naught here and RE parallel to R naught here. Okay. Simply just modifying the gain, input impedance and output impedance, found for emitter follower without R naught. So we have already done that. So to include this effect of R naught, we simply make R naught parallel to RE in all these equations. So for example, here also RE is present, simply keep R naught in parallel. Here also RE is present, simply keep R naught in parallel. Okay. So these three values we had already calculated. So I'll show you. Okay. For example, the gain. Okay. So gain we had calculated here. Yes, here, right. So this is R out we have calculated. So let us say R out is here. So this much was calculated earlier. RS by beta plus 1, 1 by GM parallel to RA. Okay. So now simply we have to make R naught also in parallel here. Okay. So if you are considering the effect of early effect. Okay. So these things can be modified by inspection only. So I think we should stop here now because the time is also over. So we'll stop.